Yesterday, myself and the Roshis, representing our church, were at the annual meeting of the Central Atlantic Conference of the United Church of Christ. I am now going to tell you everything that happened there in intricate detail. I hope you brought pillows. No, I won't. But I did not pick today's readings, though, in order to fit with the themes of this particular annual meeting. I relied instead upon that time-honored tradition of every lazy preacher in the history of the church. We followed the lectionary, which tells us exactly what we can preach upon every year and goes through a three-year cycle. But the set texts today in the lazy preacher's lectionary could not be more fitting for the message that was shared at that meeting. They represent change, they represent hope, they represent growth in the midst of confusion. The anointing not only of a person in David, but also the bright hope for a new future for a disillusioned people searching for meaning and definition in the world. The story of a small seed growing into a home for the birds, reaching down into the soil and reaching up toward the sky. The kingdom of heaven from an impossibly small start, becoming a greater and greater and more inclusive home. The boy shepherd with beautiful eyes, impossibly anointed to lead a new and brighter future for a people who do not even know who he is. We begin our reading from 1 Samuel with Samuel the prophet, the former judge of Israel, the former leader, and Saul, still the king of Israel, separating and going their own ways. Saul's rule had been full of hope and promise. It had been blessed by God and met with the acclaim of the people. He was who they wanted to lead him. He looked, he acted, probably even smelled like a king, whatever that smells like. The people wanted Saul as a ruler. They wanted everything that came with having a king over them, even though many of those things that we listed last week out, like putting people in front of chariots and taking most of your money to do things for the kingdom, sounded difficult. But ultimately, it did not work. It caused heartache for Samuel, and we can be sure that the loss of the friendship and the advisement of Samuel grieved Saul greatly. It did not work. And we are left with regret that this way of doing things